only have a minute and a half, and I don't really need to hear what you're trying to provide. I want to know how you're dealing with all these conspiracy theorists on your platform.
So what happens now is that when you go into Google and you just write any number, any three numbers followed by new cases, you get different sets of coronavirus reports. So no matter what number you put here, this is what Mike said, was posting on Facebook today, and I thought it was impossible, so I decided to check. You put any number and you get a number of news, any number you want.
So the first way is by demoting low quality content and promoting more authoritative content. And
you're gonna get, so 446, you get Kazakhstan cases, 446 new cases. If you put 777 new cases.
And the second is by providing more transparency for users. So
there you go, 777 new cases of coronavirus.
And so we're introducing boxes that provide factual information at the top of results that have shown themselves to turn up a lot of information that is counterfactual, such as
made a very welcome discovery in the fight against COVID. A low-cost, widely used anti-inflammatory has improved the chances of survival for seriously ill patients. Now, this is the first treatment so far.
A randomized trial showed it reduced death rates by a third in patients on ventilators and by a fifth in patients receiving oxygen.
It really is showing quite a significant effect. And it's really important because the drug itself is very widely available. It's on almost every pharmacy shelf in every hospital. It's available throughout the world and it's extremely cheap. So we've looked at the numbers, and if we treat 8 patients in intensive care with this drug, we'll save 1 life. And the total cost of treating all 8 patients is only about £40.